Hi, Jason here from TGN. Okay, from previous episode, okay, we have done the unboxing for the Balance 20X. At the same time, the following episode, we did an installation of the expansion set for the Balance 20X. Okay, so for today's video, we'll be covering on the speed test. Okay, so we will be conducting two different speed tests, one of which will be from the base unit, which is using a Cat 4 modem. All right, and in this case, for my video today, I have a Cat 12 LTEA modem inserted inside and installed, which I will definitely show you again, and then we will show you the speed test. Alright, so from here we will now go into the GUI, the graphic user interface of the Peplink unit. Okay. So over here we will put in our username password. Okay. So upon entering, okay, you can see that both my SIM cards are connected, and you can see that my cellular one, okay, I'm having an IP number of 119.234.44.127. Okay, and it's connected on normal LTE 4G. Okay, and my secondary, which is my expansion here, I have connected on 119.234.51.33. Okay, and you can see that it's on LTEA. Alright, so for the first test, what we're going to do is I'm going to go to the network and I'm going to disconnect my LTEA. Okay, so I'm going to trigger to disconnect my LTEA. Okay, and what's going to happen is we're just going to have on the standard 4G LTE. Okay, so which is on 44.127. Okay, so I'm going to run a speed test, and to make sure that we are on the correct WAN IP, I'm going to do a refresh, and you can see here it's now at 44.127. Okay, so this is on Cat 4 LTE. I'm going to change the server to a local Singapore Singtel server. Alright, and let's click go and take a look. Okay, at the same time while it's running the download and upload, we have to monitor the ping, and also as it completes, we have to look also at the jitter. Okay, we want to see what kind of speed we're going to get for the Cat 4. Okay, so this is Cat 4 LTE. We're getting a very good distance of 56 megabits. Okay, 56 megabits per second. Let's take a look at the upload. Okay. The upload in this case for today, we got 43. We're averaging about 43 megabits per second. Okay, so which is a very, very healthy. Let's take a look at the jitter and see what kind of jitter we're going to get for the Cat 4. Okay, so let's see what does it show. Right, so in this case, jitter doesn't come up. Okay, but at least we know that we got 56 and 43 for the Cat 4 for the Balance 20X. Okay, this is on the Singtel SIM cards. Right, so let's go back to the GUI again. I will connect the LTEA and I will disconnect the standard 4G LTE. Okay, and let's take a look at our WAN IP now as we are connecting to the LTEA. Okay, let's give it a short moment and let's see what we get. Okay, let it load for a while. Okay. What are we seeing here? Okay, the RSSI is good. We have a negative 48 dBm. Alright, so in this case, we have a 5133. Okay, we have a 5133. Let's take a look at our speed test. Let's do a quick refresh. Okay, to ensure that we are getting the right IP number. Okay, so in this case, it's 5133 and it's loading now. And then we can just click go and see what we're going to get. Okay. So let's select Singtel again, as usual. And let's go. Okay, so right now we're having a ping of 25 milliseconds. Okay, and we're hitting about 120, close to 120. Okay, so we should maybe most likely end up with about 121. Okay, we have about 121 or 123 megabits, 122 megabits on the LTEA Cat 12 modem. Okay, for download. For upload, we are getting right now, we are getting about, what do you get? 60, 66, okay? Close to 70, okay? So 70 should be a very healthy mark for LTEA Cat 12, okay? So we got 122 and 74, okay? So going back to the GUI, okay, let's see here. The next thing that we want to check is to make sure to click on details to see if we are getting CA, okay? So in this case, on the network, we're actually getting LTEA CA download, downlink and uplink, okay? So it's basically we are getting really real real speed of close to real speed of a Cat 12. Okay, but we are on only band 3, which is 1800 megahertz, right? So end of the day, basically what happens is, what we have done is we have shown that on the Cat 4 and the Cat 12 modem, you can see there's a difference, okay? And with the Balance 20X, it allows you to have the option to change, okay? Of course, you can leave your Cat 4 as your Cat 4 modem as a primary or secondary modem and expand it onto a Cat 12 modem to enjoy a much faster speed on your 4G connectivity. Now, not forgetting that this unit, okay, it has also a standard WAN port. And of course, you will still enjoy the speed fusion, all right? So long as you make sure that the Balance 20X has its Prime Care subscription valid, all right? You need to make sure that your Prime Care subscription is valid and you will enjoy all the speed fusion technology, okay? So this concludes my video for today. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like our video. All right, see you next time.